With me in the studio now is Europa Oil and Gas's Hugh Mackay. Hugh, good morning to you. Good to see you.
Good morning.
A big big morning for you. You've announced the results of a competent persons report for two new prospects offshore Ireland. We're talking Ervine and Edgeworth. What have you learned? What have been some of the headlines to come out of that?
Well, there's been a lot going on for us in Ireland over the last few weeks. So this is culmination of several months' work on LO16-2, working with our proprietary 3D. And we've come up with three prospects, Ervine, Edgeworth, both of which we felt were sufficiently mature to go to ERC Equipoise for a competent persons report. And that report has now been published, hence the RNS and the two prospects. The combined gross mean unrisked prospective resources are 553 million barrels. Both are above the 200 million barrel threshold that we regard as the economic limit for offshore Ireland. The third prospect, PR3, which we're not giving a name yet, but will do once it reveals itself properly. The seismic quality wasn't good enough to justify taking forward to ERC. So the next program of work for this license is to reprocess the 3D volume over 16.2 and 3.13. It's all part of the same data set. And we are very confident that that is going to uplift the seismic quality, enabling us to map faults better and to have greater clarity on what's going on inside the fault blocks. And hopefully we'll de-risk the prospects from where they are now, which is about 1 in 7 and 1 in 8, down to more like 1 in 5, and most importantly, convert them into drillable prospect status.
And just to drive home the point, Ervine and Edgeworth, both of those individually are above that crucial 200 million barrel mark, so they're economically viable.
Yeah, and it shouldn't be a surprise. You know, they're part of the pre-rift play, so it's different to the Cretaceous fans and the next door license, FEL 313. The analogue for the pre-rift play is the Brent province in the North Sea, which has reserves of 15 billion barrels. So, you know, we're in the right ballpark for, you know, if the analogy is correct. And there's plenty room in the South Porcupine to fit two or three Brent provinces in. So, you know, it's if it's as prolific as Brent, then we're off to, we're potentially off to the races on just this license alone.
More broadly for offshore Ireland, what are we talking now? Audited barrels of whereabouts?
Oh, well,
over 2 billion?
2 billion, that's correct. So ERC Equipoise have audited FEL 313, which is next door, and we put that out in 2015. So there's 1.5 billion barrels in FEL 313, 553 in 16.2 audited barrels. So that's 2 billion barrels of oil, audited resources. Mm-hmm. So, you know, the market should feel comfortable that there's a lot of technical integrity standing behind these figures, which are very large. And in the South Porcupine, broadly across our four licenses, we've identified gross prospective resources of over 4 billion barrels. And that's a combination of the 2 billion audited and another 2 billion unaudited. So we have potentially got a very, very strong position. And I suppose best of all, in June, Providence are going to spud a well to test the Druid and Drombeg prospects. And if that well comes in, it's going to de-risk the entire basin. The read across for Europa is it's going to de-risk 4.2 billion barrels, of which 2 billion is an audited resource. So we'll be watching that carefully, because if it's a positive outcome, then it's going to be very important for Europa. And positive outcomes, you know, obviously would be finding movable oil, but even simple things like finding viable reservoir, defining source rock, defining the phase of hydrocarbon is all very important to de-risk all of the plays. It's not just Cretaceous fans anymore. Mm-hmm. Paleocene, Cretaceous fans, Cretaceous slope, pre-rift and syn-rift. So there's a lot to play for in offshore Ireland, and it's not going to be killed by one bad well, but one good well would be enormously helpful for everyone, but especially Europa.
And of course, farm out agreements and discussions underway and continuing?
Absolutely. We've got one away on 16.19 with Cairn, and that's now been approved by the Minister of Energy, so that's done. And the next, Cairn are now the operator with 70%, and we will be shooting seismic this summer. TGS will be acquiring the seismic, and more information will be coming up on start dates and the boat over the next few months. And on that license 1619, I hope that by next summer, a process product and a prospect inventory at the end of 2018, and then we can think about what we might want to drill. And obviously, if the Drombeg well is a success, then there may be a great deal more urgency on wanting to drill sooner rather than later.
Absolutely. So a significant morning here for you. Hugh, just while I've got you, Wrestle, what's the latest as far as planning permissions concerned?
Okay, everything's on track. The Egdon put out, well, we all put out an RNS the other week. As you know, there's a twin track approach. We're going for a planning appeal and redetermination. Planning appeal has already been submitted. The redetermination, which is essentially going through the planning permission process all over again, this time with more information on water, that has been submitted. It should be duly made next week, and then that kicks off a 13-week planning application process as if we were submitting it all over again. So all the statutory consultees who had previously said yes have to go through it all over again. But hopefully this summer we may get planning permission if the planning committee see fit to do so, and then we can crack on and bring Wrestle onto production. It should have been on production now, so we've lost about 6 months, but with a fair wind, we should be able to get that on production towards the end of the year. So that would be good. An extra 100 barrels a day net to Europa would be very helpful.
Certainly would. Plenty happening now, and plenty to look forward to, Hugh. Thanks very much for coming in.
Thank you.